This is the Welcome Center for Celadon out here at 33rd and Post Road on the city's east side. About 3,500 people work for Celadon, and all of them are wondering what's down the road this week. Trucks are coming home to Celadon's transit center, called back to Indy after last week's word of the indictments of two former top executives who allegedly defrauded the company and its shareholders of $60 million in stock value. By mid-afternoon, a trucker who didn't want her name used because she feared Celadon might back out on helping her said at least 30 drivers were stranded in Indianapolis.
All of a sudden, their gas cars just stopped for working. They got them back on, but now they're not working again. People are stranded. There's people that are broke down that on the side of the road. Some of them didn't have enough gas. Some of them were told that they could put gas in it out of their own pocket.
Celadon has about 2,700 trucks that run from Canada to Mexico, and there were some rigs leaving the terminal today. The one driver said he's never seen so many parked trucks and trailers there before. While industry stock researchers anticipate Celadon will file bankruptcy this week, truckers tell me they've heard the company has lost three of its biggest customers, and the drivers and their supporters share what little bit of information they have through social media.
And it has been numerous of posts that I've seen people saying, hey, look, I'm stuck here in St. Louis. I'm stuck here in Kansas. I'm stuck, you know, here in Baltimore. I've called the job. No one's answering. My fuel car is still not working. If you can give me a lift to, you know, get back home, then that would be well appreciated.
The one driver who would agree to talk to me broke down when she thought of being stuck in Indy, hundreds of miles from her home and child, and when I asked her what was her biggest worry.
Christmas for my kids.
Do you have any way to get home?
No. I just want to go home.
Drivers for Celadon told me they've been told to hold on until Monday for a meeting with company officials and a plan to get them home. Meanwhile, no one at the Celadon headquarters was available for comment. On the city's east side, Russ McQuaid, Fox 59 News.
Still a lot to